This video is intended to show the basic use and operation of a model 3001-3RK2 response kit. This video is only intended to provide general guidelines about the equipment. Users should develop their own procedures in accordance with regulatory and or local requirements. In this video, we refer to exposure rate, R per hour, as dose rate, since that's the most commonly used vernacular. All parameters such as unit display and alarm levels are set to factory default settings. The model 3001 has four buttons on the face of the instrument. The on-act button is used to turn the 3001 on and off and to acknowledge an alarm. Turn on the 3001 by pressing the on-act button for about 1 second. The 3001 will go through a boot-up process and the display will flash all the segments of the display. Then it will show the firmware number, followed by the battery voltage. The instrument can be turned off by pressing the on-act button for approximately 4 seconds. The unit will do a countdown of 3, 2, 1, and then we'll be off. The units button allows the user to change the units on the display. The detector button is used to select the active detector. Each detector in the kit is labeled with its corresponding detector number. The mode button is used to change the mode of the 3001. Pressing it once will enter the max mode, which holds the highest reading obtained since entering that mode or the last reset. Pressing it again will enter the count mode. This is used to take a time count and that will then display the result at the end of the count time. Detector number one is the model 44-9 pancake type GM detector. The 44-9 can detect alpha, beta, and gamma radiation. The 44-9 is calibrated to read in either dose rate or counts per minute on the detector 1 setting. Again, you can change the display units by pressing the units button on the model 3001. With the unit sets for dose rate, the display will indicate either microwatt per hour or milliwatt per hour depending on the radiation level. At low level readings near background, the numbers will vary up and down, but this is normal. You have to watch the meter for several seconds and then you can get an idea of the average reading. The 44-9 can measure dose rate from 1 mR to 1 R per hour. If you need to measure higher than 1 R per hour, you need to switch to the model 133-6 detector that's also in the kit. Connect detector number 1, which is the model 44-9, to the C cable. Ensure that the detector number 1 setting is illuminated on the model 3001. The protective cap may be left on the detector when measuring gamma or X-ray radiation. However, the cap will block beta and alpha radiation. So the cap must be removed when measuring those. Detector number 2 is the model 44-2 gamma scintillator. The 44-2 is designed to detect low levels of gamma radiation. It cannot detect alpha or beta radiation. The 44-2 can be used to measure from background levels in the single microwatt up to 50 mR per hour. If you need to measure higher dose rates than that, you need to switch to the model 44-9 or the model 133-6. The model 44-2 is designed to detect gamma radiation. Detector number 3 is the model 133-6 GM detector. It's designed to detect high levels of gamma radiation from 200 mR up to 800 mR per hour. The model 133-6 is also energy compensated to be more accurate over a wide range of energies. That concludes this video on the model 3001-3RK2.